Good morning, everyone. Good morning. Good morning. What a great SportAccord we've been having. And we continue our panels on innovation, and we continue the sports and business section today. My name is Charmaine Crooks, and on behalf of myself and David Eads, it's a pleasure to be your moderators for these segments. Today's sessions will again cover the innovation in sport. And we're going to begin our day with a presentation from our organizing committee. Then we're going to have a presentation by one of our new sports, the IF of Sambo. And then we're going to have a panel session on technology, friend or foe. But let's kick it off today with a presentation from our friends from Tokyo 2020. We all know that Tokyo 2020 is set to be the most innovative games ever. And they are on pace to do that and to bring history to the world through the innovation that they will showcase there in their venues and how they will produce the games in 2020. So please welcome to the stage Mr. Eiji Ude, Chief Technology Innovation Officer for the 2020 Tokyo Olympic Games.
Thank you very much.
Good morning. Ladies and gentlemen, so thank you for joining this event. Since it's my great honor to have the opportunity to make a presentation in front of great people like you. So and now so that I'm going to so introduce my presentation. I work for the IT industry for more than 30 years. Then therefore, so the IT matter for me is very good, easy to explain. But so that I'm quite amateur of sports. But so that I'm going to introduce our challenges from now. Today, so I'm going to introduce innovation plans. So for sports, for SPX, so and for sustainabilities. And so I would like to introduce legacy and economic effects. In fact, in Tokyo, 1964, we held the Olympic Games. Since then, we have grown very rapidly. Then, I would like to introduce a big impact effectiveness of the Olympic. And also, we can show our future. And also, I want to introduce the other innovation challenges. Today, I'm going to introduce these matters. Okay. So it comes from the cabinet office, and now the Japanese cabinet office are also focusing on the innovation, and aiming at 2020. I will introduce a part of this. For example, the innovation plan for sports. This is a visualization of sports. Reference cases, table tennis and volleyball. Maybe? Just a moment. We can calculate every height and speed and everything, like this. Then technology itself is already developed, but we still have improved how to apply this technology to the gaming. Then from now we are going to develop the technology here. On the other hand, we need to develop the content and application from now until 3 years. Then so it means so about the tennis this moment. Table tennis. Excuse me. Like this, so, and also I'd like to introduce so the judgment assistant. So now so that we are now planning to so utilize this technology for the judgment of so the athlete performances. Then so the, in fact the recently so the performance is improving very rapidly. Then on the other hand, we don't have so the improvement in the, for the judge. Therefore, this is one of the challenge for us. So gymnastic scoring, so the innovation that, then so the we will.
Fujitsu's 3D sensing technology captures gymnast performance in real time and create difficulty score sheet at the same time.
As you know well,
after so the performance, the system automatically calculates the score and then judges confirm it.
This is the, so the judgment assistance system, not the, just the system will never so that a judge by himself, but this be one of so the challenge. So of course, as I told you before, saying so that we are now so developed many so technologies, then so the from now so the how to utilize this technology to make the sports more so the fun and exciting. This is our so the content and application is very important. And on the other hand, so the for SPX, spectators' experience, this is one of so the good opportunity. A long time ago, so the high, do you know so that this is a pictogram? We developed this in 1964. Now, so the, this pictogram is worldwide. Then right now, so that we are making so the digital so signages. This is one of the reference cases. So when they arrive in the airport, so we are now developing so the mobile application to so the guide to so the near the light destination, and very so effectively. Of course, now so that we are planning to so that utilize so multi-language so the guideline that. And so the departure time, then so I already used a trial, this application. So not just as a photo, but photo shooting, but just as I clicked some sort of mark, then at that time, so the application will come to my so mobile phone, so the very easily. And I can access many places. Also, the very important thing is that so safety so and security. Then so you may know that so there are very big issue because of the, we need to check the, so the security. Then after all, then so the many audiences have to so wait for a long time to enter the, so the game. Then after all, so the, some cases they couldn't watch the, so the game itself. So in that there is a case. Then we need to make more smooth entrance, but also the high with the high security area. Then we are not going to utilize this face recognition system. This is one of the challenge for us. And you may know that projection mapping. This is Rio's opening ceremony. Then Panasonic is a Japanese company provided this projection mapping that almost all you know very well. At that time, we utilized 2K pixel, but now we are planning to the 8K pixel in Tokyo 2020. So this gap is very huge. Probably 8K pixel will be a sort of a real one.
Then suddenly, the images became stereoscopic. The curtain-like screen had appeared. An infinite number of butterflies fluttered.
If so, in the Rio Olympic Games, Rio Olympics committee made a great effort, and then he faced a little bit difficult budget difficulties. Then they fully utilized this technology. After all, it's a very productive, very low cost, but high performances. This is one of the big project. Then we want to realize much higher quality and fun. And this is also the multi view by three visual technology, 3D, three dimension.
This is the Power Stadium. It was designed with the concept of building excitement and converting it into energy for the community. Boost the excitement produced at the stadium and channel it to increase business opportunities. As well, in case of emergency, it will also function as an energy station. The future entertainment space is furnished with those two functions. The new concept created direction of lighting, sound, and video produces an unprecedented inspiring space and bring business opportunities as well. That's Big Lock. Infinite angles caught by countless cameras. All kinds of screens, including a giant screen, display a defining moment. And each and every spectator freely chooses their viewpoint, selects information, and experiences the whole stadium. Produced along with the ambient audio to create your unique viewing experience. According to the situation in the game, the insertion of distribution media and advertisement can be instantaneously controlled. It gives an experience that is even better than the live one. It can also lead to business promotion-like advertisement linked with all media and sales promotion support by analyzing the flow of people. What supports the play is field lighting designed to eliminate shadows. 4K and 8K high-definition TV broadcasting is supported too. For the exterior of the stadium, there is lighting for which colors can be controlled freely. It provides original expression depending on the game situation or the nature of the event. By diversifying the functions of the stadium, it can support various events. For example, an exhibition of a club team, a concert, an art event, and a conference. It creates new possibilities for the building to act as an entertainment facility, not limited to being a stadium. Self-support energy supplies available, providing safety and security of the community during an emergency and energy-saving features at ordinary times. expand business by creating a sensation beyond a live event, which will then function as an important energizing force for the community. Sensation bringing energy to the community and create new business. That is Power Stadium.
So this is a very important sort of concern because, for example, so that now, so that as you, all of you know well, so the technology for the broadcasting and internet and so digital solution will be helpful to watch for us to watch without any special effort to visit the stadium or something. Therefore, so that we need to make more sort of value and so the interest to the for the sort of spectators to come to the sort of game stadium venue. It's one of the very big important things that. Then so the, of course the, this will help for and so the probably it will make so the people interest into the come to the sort of stadium to watch the real one and so the digital. This is so only one way for the, so to make this so the audience or spectators so the attractive. Okay, it's one of so the important challenge for us. Otherwise, many people can see just only so the TV. Then so innovation plan for sustainability. This is quite different from the sports, but taking this opportunity, I would like to so that we would like to the Japanese would like to introduce the excellence of so the technology for society. Now, so that I'd like to introduce the recycled energy and the hydrogen. So. Itself is a two-way communication by itself. Then so the, my point is that so that you know well so that now so the recently so the so electric vehicle EV is become very common and we're hybrid, but so the hydrogen the different thing is that so that as you could see that there's only so the fill up time is only 3 minutes. And also, now so that we are challenging to, but many people may say that, so that even hydrogen is so CO2 zero emission, but in the, under the, in the process of so generation of the hydrogen, we still are making some so CO2. Then, therefore, our challenge is that, for example, so that we have an opportunity, Japan is a very so the, one of the so leading company for the so solar power generation in the countrywide. Then therefore, once we could get so the electric power by solar, and then so that we will use so that this as energy electric energy to generate the hydrogen. At the time, so that totally so that we can realize so the CO2 zero emission. This is, of course, this is very important for the energy issue, but also the pollution issue. Then this is one of the good reference cases. And so the different thing is that usually so that we need to make so the metal, gold, silver, and so the bronze. Then at the time, so totally around 5,000 metals. But so the, now so we assessed so the now we are planning to recycle from so the electric devices. Then, so for example, we investigated so the resources, precious metal resources. Then, so already so the upper ground, the on-ground resources much bigger than the underground resources in every areas, except the aluminum. Then, so that we need to utilize this on-ground resources. Now, we already announced countrywide. Then, we asking all people to participate this project. Then, let's make your gold Olympic medal by yourself. Then, this is one of the challenge for us. Then, we already started the project and it well accepted. It has been very well accepted by all people. And so the one of the different importance of the matter is this, so the legacy and the economic effects. As I told you, so the legacy of Tokyo 1964, then as you can see that, so the in 1964, the GDP was $262 billion, but right now, $4,360 billion. Means 1,700% growth. In conjunction with the population is only 30% increase. Then individual average GDP has grown more than 15%, 550%. This is just one of the very big gap. Oh, sorry, 1,500%, 15 times. Then, therefore, it's a very great event in Japan, in the history. Then, at the time, Shinkansen, bullet train, and developed, and the metropolitan highway developed. Right now, the metropolitan highway is expanded countrywide, then more than 9,000 kilometers. Then, for example, right now, Shinkansen is like this. And now we are challenging to the linear motor car. Linear motor car will exceed probably 500 kilometer per hour. Then it must be the fastest transportation project. Now we already developed linear motor car. Then today, Tokyo. Tokyo is only a very small city, totally around less than 1% of total Japan areas. Then, but the pollution population is 13.6 million. Then, 10%, more than 10% of total population in Japan. Then, GDP is around $863 billion, and also the budget. Only metropolitan budget is more than $100 billion. Then, therefore. therefore, it be around, it deserves around Sweden or other countries' national budget. Then this is the legacy of the last Tokyo Olympic. Then now I'm going to talk about the economic effect from the Tokyo 2020. Then right now, already the Tokyo Metropolitan Government announced the estimation about the return of the investment around 32 trillion yen. 30 trillion yen means $30 billion. Then the return of investment around 20 times, because we are now planning to invest 1.5 trillion yen. Yes. Then that means around 115 billion dollar. Then return will be 20 times. Then this assumption is just the duration between 2013 to 2030. There, but this comes from just only the construction and operational and the tourism. Then, on the other hand, we can expect much more things that. This is, for example, then the tourists are visiting increasing drastically. Then once we announced the Tokyo Olympic Games, the visitor, income visitor, tourist is growing very fast. And their spending is also very big. And the other topics is that, so the this is one of the very important things, because Japan's very big national issue is so the medical cost and the aged people's population. Then, as you can see that, so the now so the so number of so the aged people, the elderly people, so the older than the 65 years old, now so they're growing very fast. And the next one is also national healthcare cost. It costs 78 trillion yen. 78 trillion yen means $780 billion. It's very huge. Then on the other hand, so the, we have a very good reference case. Once the sports promoted in the, this is a reference case in the small village, then so the elderly people, or almost all the elderly people join, participate, just so the sports in the very, so the positively. Now afterwards, total expense of so the medical cost decreased around 88%. Once we can so the this number to adapt the total so the national healthcare cost, then it's so we can expect as a 6 trillion yen per year. Then only 1 year, so that we can expect the medical cost reduction around so 6 trillion yen. This is a very big so the impact, effectiveness. Therefore, I truly think that we should promote by the sports that was countrywide and by using so the Tokyo Olympic 2020. Then so the others, so the, for example, Japan was selected as so the UNESCO World Heritage. Then so the Japanese food, was selected as so the national the UNESCO heritage. Then so flower is also one of so the challenges by so the cabinet. Then so the, we'd like to so introduce many so the fun and so the attractiveness for the, all so the foreign visitors by using this traditional so the inn. This will be a very effective for the small medium enterprise and the very small hotel or so the Japanese traditional inn. Then so it's be a one of good so the opportunity to promote this business. And this is the Mount Fuji. Then so the, this is a flower innovation that. And so the Japan is very popular so the, for the fireworks. Then so the, in fact so the Rios, so the, also the every event so the, made so the great so the how I would say so the fireworks. But Japan so the master is very great. Then they can make many kind, many attractive so the fireworks. Then it will be one of good things for you. Okay. And so the food, you know well, so the sushi is very popular. Then the, in fact, the, so the, please understand, so sushi in Japan is absolutely different, very high quality than any other countries. Then and so you can enjoy that. But many times, so the, as you can see that, so the Tokyo was selected as the number one, so the Michelin stars. But so the, this is not only that, that's a luxury. I'm sorry, so the Paris, the now so the we so the overachieved that. Then but so the now so the not only just a luxury so food restaurant, but also we have many kind of very so the reasonable or sometimes a very cheaper food, but very delicious, high quality, hygiene. Then so the, you can enjoy like this cost. Then ramen and so the many other so the, for example, curry comes from India, but the Japanese curry is much better. Okay. Then, so the, for example, oh yes, McDonald's is a very important so sponsor of so Iowa City, just taking this. Then, so the Japan's ranking is around, so this rank is just so the pricing. Then, so the, in fact, so Japan, so the big market is also very good. And then we made so the special, so Japan special McDonald's. Then, so the teriyaki. Teriyaki is a so very popular Japanese food. Okay. And you know well, so that this is so the many so characters. Then so that we didn't have so the fixed yet, but so that we were going to utilize. As you may remember that so the Prime Minister Abe so the wear the costume of this so the Mario in the at the end of the closing ceremony of so the Olympic game. Then so the Japan people fully utilize the people, even though so he's the so prime minister to to promote so the Tokyo 2020. That now also this is one of the good challenges. So the VR and also the so the and so virtual reality and also the so the some so wheels. So the then so the it so this is the one of good important things that but good and important things because. Many people are concerned how to so the attractiveness of so the Paralympic game. Probably many people have experience, for example, baseball or soccer or any other sport. Then therefore they could be interested in just a game. Then, but we didn't have opportunity to experience so the Paralympic game. Then we want to sort of make some sort of idea to. Give some experience to for over so the Paralympic game. This is now so I'm going to utilize this virtual reality and so the many so the equipment. Then so the many people will be interested in just so the Paralympic games. Then and so Tokyo preparation status that Japan located the far east, very tiny country. But so growing rapidly. Now we're going to develop the, so the main stadium here.
In 2016年12月、いよいよ建設が始まる。多くの人の思いと情熱とともに工事は着実に進む。
Now, so that we are developing 2018 August, we will make so the sort of roof. We call this a sort of stadium in the world. Roof. Then, so that we will sort of make so the combination with the nature and so the artificial. Then so we are going, it will be so accomplished before 7 months for the Olympic Games in 2019 November.
この神宮の森の中にこれからの100年を見据えて立つ新しい国立競技場緑豊かな周辺の環境と緩やかにつながり日本らしく佇む 木と緑のスタジアム。日本の伝統的な建築の特徴である軒びさしが柔らかな陰影を作り、温かい温度を表現した。Everything is still not yet.
We are aiming at the best performance for athletes in this stadium. Also, that the spectator also can enjoy everything. See you in Tokyo. Thank you very much.